Hey, anybody watching this, so you're watching this video, which means you probably are at home, don't have any weights or equipment, and you came to the right video. So first thing I wanted to talk about was the reason I'm making this video is because going into lockdown again, gyms are probably gonna be closed. So I thought, hey, maybe if I do a workout with no weights, this is gonna get views. But all jokes aside, I made this workout because I wanted to show people that you can gain strength, gain muscle, get results without using weights. Now this is a back and bicep workout, and number one thing that comes to mind when you think of biceps are just doing a ton of bicep curls. And I just wanted to show that you don't need dumbbells to get bigger biceps, or just get stronger in general. You can get stronger at home with your body weight. Obviously, there is one thing that I think you should invest in, and that is a pull-up bar. If you are going to make the journey into exercising, is a pull-up bar. It's the number one tool, really the only tool that you need to build a well-rounded physique with your body weight. But it's possible, and I want to give you guys a realistic view of things from my point of view and what I've done. And I started out before I was blessed with this amazing setup that I have. I only did bodyweight exercise. And the awesome thing about bodyweight exercises is you can make them harder by just changing up the grips via push-ups, hand placement, pull-ups, wide, close, in. But besides that, I just wanted to talk about, well, I'm having a major deja vu moment right now. Like, I was wearing this exact, okay, but I wanted to talk about Instagram influencers and YouTube creators. Now, a thing about these influencers, and I'm not trying to say any hate or pick on anyone specifically, but they make these videos, you'll see them, like little 8-minute ab workouts or booty workouts and like little circuits where it's like swipe for the next workout and stuff or next exercise. And yeah, those are cool at first. Let's say you're just starting out and you do them for like a couple months, but they put out videos of stuff they don't actually do. And what I mean by that is they'll go to the gym, they'll go to the park or wherever, and they'll go with their camera and they'll record the workout, the video, but they don't actually do that workout themselves. It's just for the video because it looks cool, it'll make them money. So what I want to do is show you guys a workout that doesn't involve any weights. You can do at home if you have a pull-up bar at least, or a fence, or anything you can do pull-ups on, that'll get you results, one, and two, that is something that I actually do. With all honesty, I can't count the number of times I've done this workout, probably like more than 10 times, because it feels good and it's hard, it challenges you. So yeah, I actually do this. I've gotten results from it. As you can see, not crazy, my body isn't abnormal or anything, but these people you see posting booty circuits or 8-minute ab videos with tons of different types of crunches, they 99% of the time they don't actually do that. You ever see a guy deadlifting 600 pounds and he puts out a workout with body weight squats and push-ups and you wonder like, man, this is probably how he deadlifts 600 pounds? No, that's not how he does it. Yeah, these circuits that they post on Instagram and stuff, they're cool, they look cool, they make them money, and I, honestly, no shade towards them. They're geniuses for doing what they do, because people do it, people believe it, and they make money off of people. So yeah, but you're not gonna get a 600 pound deadlift by doing body weight squats. You're not gonna get the Instagram bodies that some of these female models have by doing like those pulsing squats with no weight. Yeah, it'll get you to a certain point, but after that, you'll stop making progress, because that's not what they actually do. And that's just what I wanted to point out. And I wanted to show you guys what I actually do to make progress. So yeah, I guess we'll just get on with the video. Thanks for watching.
Hey guys, so today's gonna be a back and bicep workout and shoulders, but like the other two heads of the shoulder. So yeah. But I bet that you would love that. Dutch and bad vibes, like skirt. Drama on my line, like skirt. That's been in the past, like skirt. Quick tip, when you guys are doing the pull-ups, the 5 sets of 5, or chin-ups, just any pull variation on a bar, make sure you get a full range of motion. You want to fully feel the stretch on your lats. So this is what I'm talking about. I'm going to show what it looks like from the front and the back.
So normally when people do a pull-up, you'll go down and you'll stop, but you want to go really let your scapula go down. So this is what it looks like from the back. This is just like half rep all the way. So yeah, just focus on those last 2 inches. And those last 2 inches will really help you feel the activation on your lats when you're doing the pull-up. Another thing with the rows, if you guys are doing the rows and they're too hard, this is what you could do to make them easier. Because by the time you get to the row part of the workout, you're usually pretty tired. So I actually do this myself. Because if you try to do all 5 sets of rows like this, you're gonna get way too tired. Or at least you're not gonna get tired, but your muscles will start to fatigue. So to make them easier, just scoot your feet up. By like the 5th set, my feet are literally like this, and my body's like this. So yeah, just something to help you guys out, make it easier to get through the workout, because if you keep trying to do them flat-footed and straight, your muscles will be too tired to continue. It's never gonna change, I'm gonna feel this way forever. Are you gonna be around for me to count on? Is it never gonna change? I'm gonna you guys just saw was a body weight curl. So you're essentially doing curls with your body weight without dumbbells. And I really like this exercise because you can really feel the peak contraction when you pull. You can just feel it in your bicep like crazy. But when doing this exercise, focus on not using your back at all and just contract your bicep by moving your elbow joint, and you'll get the best benefits from doing it like that. And like you'll really feel pumped after doing the sets of pull-ups and rows, because your biceps will already be on fire, and the curls just add on to that. So yeah, like every exercise I'm showing in this video, the low bar face pulls, the body rows, the pull-ups, chin-ups, you want to go slow and controlled and just focus on the range of motion and the contraction of the muscle. Don't try to pump them out. And when you're doing the face pulls, you're going to pull to your head, pull to your forehead, or your face, or anywhere. So yeah, this is my dinner. Just one of those Marie Callender frozen chicken pot pies, an orange or whatever these things are called, and my shake. So that's the video. Thank you for watching. If you liked it, like, leave a comment, subscribe. See you guys next time.